So my name is Ken Olson. I am an extension beef specialist with South Dakota State University. Today, what I'd like to talk to you about is how to take a sample of forage that mimics what the cow eats. Why do we care about mimicking the cow? The reason for that is because we know that cows are very selective in choosing what they eat among everything you see out here in the pasture that they're in. They have pretty wide variety of choices. There are several species of grasses in this pasture. They're a little harder to see because the grass is so tall, but there's forbs in this pasture as well. And in a lot of pastures, there'll be shrubs. And grazing animals select from among all those different choices that they have. And the reason that they're selective is so that they can gain a high nutrition diet. And their selectivity actually allows them to graze a diet that's always higher in nutritional value than the average of everything that's out here. So if we come out in this pasture and say, listen, we want a sample of the forage in this pasture, we can either clip it to ground level, we can weigh that and give us a really good estimate of how much forage is out here. But if we really want to have a sample that represents the nutritional value of their diet, then we have to mimic what the cow does. And so that's what today's video is about. We're now down at ground level in our spot that we're going to sample. And as I look at this spot, I can see that I have plants grazed at about three different levels. And I'm going to sample each of those levels because it could be the same cow chose to graze kind of high, then a medium level, then a low level. It could have been different cows. The point is, three different bites got taken, and I want a sample to represent all three of them. So let's start with the high one first. So right here is my plant that just got the very top clipped off. If I compare that to this plant right here that did not get grazed, we can see that my hand on the grazed plant is down here. My hand on this ungrazed plant is clear up here. So they took off some material that's nearly 6 inches of the tips of these leaves. So I'm going to reach over first with my left hand here that's at the level of grazing and grab this plant so that I know where the level I want to harvest is. Then I'm going to reach in with my right hand. I'm going to wrap around it with my fingers, somewhat like a cow would wrap around it with her tongue. And then I'm just going to tear it off. And there's my sample. Then I'm going to get my bag that I'm collecting the sample into, and I simply will put that sample in there. Now this is the bag I'm going to use for all samples in this pasture. No matter how many different species I sample or whatever, it's all going in this bag. Go to my next sample. This is the middle level one that grazed off to about here. Put this hand at that level. Over here is my ungrazed material. Notice again that if I hold them near each other, there's a difference in level of about this much. So I'm going to grab it at the grazed level. I'm going to then reach over, wrap my finger around it, and tear off the part that's above the grazed level. This is the part that we've now sampled to mimic the cow. And finally, my lowest level is down here. So if I put my right hand on the grazed level, I take my left hand and hold the material that's ungrazed. It's all sticking up above that same grazed level. Wrap my fingers around it, tear it off. There's my sample. And I put it in the bag. Now, I'm going to stand back up. If I'm walking a transect or some pathway that covers the area in the pasture the cows have grazed, I'm going to stand up. I'm going to walk to however many paces I've chosen, find my new spot, look around, find my grazed and ungrazed paired plants, get back down on my knees like I just did here, and do this over, and keep doing it until I've sampled most of the pasture. And I would like this bag to get about 2/3 to 3/4 full. That way I know I've got enough material that represents most of the grazed area in the pasture. And I also know that I'm going to send enough to the lab for them to work with to do their sampling. Okay? The last thing I need to do is pull out my trusty pen and write on this bag what this sample is. Because after a couple days, I may have this bag with other bags from other pastures or locations I've sampled, and I have no idea which bag is for which. So let's say this is the east pasture, I'll write that on there here. And then I will also add the date so that I know when this sample was taken. So today's date is August 25th, 2018. And that's now on my sample bag. So at the end of the day, we've finished walking our pathway through the pasture. We now have our sample finished. Now what are we going to do with this bag of material? Well, one thing we need to realize is if we're out here sampling green grass like we have been today, it's got a lot of moisture in it, and this sample needs to be dried. If we don't dry it, it's going to mold while it's shipping in the mail, and that's going to change its nutritional value. The sample does not need to be oven dried in the sense we take all the moisture out. It simply needs to be air dried to the point that it wouldn't mold. Any place you can put this bag where the heat of the day and perhaps the sun shining on it would cause it to warm up enough to dry it out would be more than adequate. Give it a day, 2 days at the most ought to be enough to get it to an air dry state to where it's equal with relative humidity in the air, and it'll be ready to ship to the laboratory you want to ship it to. If you go to igrow.org, we have a page on there that lists feed testing laboratories that are accredited with the Forage Testing Association that any of those would be suitable to send your sample to. You can go to their website and get their order form for the tests that you want and ship it off, and they will send results back to you. For more information on the topic that you've seen in this video today, please visit igrow.org.